Welcome to the broadcast. I'm David Feldman. Coming up on today's program, an exclusive interview with Herman Cain's wife, or possibly his widow, depending on how that meeting with her today goes. Then we are joined by UC Davis Police Chief Annette Spacuzza. Also, highlights from Sunday evening's Hollywood Christmas Parade, which was hosted by our very own Eddie Pepitone and musical guest Will Ryan. And don't forget, Eddie Pepitone's new CD, A Great Stillness, is available for download on iTunes. A great holiday gift. Speaking of holiday gifts, all week we've been hearing reports of gunfire, pepper spray, and tasers at Walmarts throughout America. Sounds like Walmart is starting to treat customers as if they were employees. Burger King announced a new recipe for their French fries, which will now be thicker with a crisper coating, just like your arteries if you eat them. Meanwhile, Wendy's fries now offer quote-unquote artisan toppings. The toppings are called artisan because there's a good chance one of them might be Vincent van Gogh's ear. The ACLU says Apple's new iPhone will not assist customers in locating abortion clinics. No surprise for iPhone users who've always known it's impossible getting any service when you want to go through a tunnel. I did that joke. It's the holiday season. Presidential candidate Herman Cain meets today with his wife to ask her two questions. One, do you want me to drop out? And two, what's your name again? All this after Cain's poll numbers dropped to single digits in Iowa. Apparently, people from Iowa don't mind raising pigs, they just won't elect one. It's been a bad week for Cain. A new woman came forward claiming she had a 13-year sexual relationship with him. Cain issued an emphatic denial, saying, "Who are you going to believe, me or a woman so dishonest she carries on a 13-year affair with a married businessman?" Cain does admit to giving his latest accuser financial help, but Cain insists he gives a lot of women financial help, especially when they keep their mouths shut. Contributions to Cain's campaign have plummeted. You know, only in the GOP would Herman Cain be considered unelectable because of adultery and not because he thinks the Taliban is in Libya. Cain's campaign could be over by next week. It's up to his wife. So for more on this, we are joined now by Mrs. Herman Cain, Sylvia Cain. Sylvia Cain, thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
What have you told him?
You know, he's a very powerful man. Godfather Pizza is now a household. You order Godfather Pizza. They call Godfather Pizza. That is because of my husband, Herman. And look at the condition of our country. It is as if the business has failed. There needs to be someone to make this a successful country the way it was and respected. And that's what he did with Godfather Pizza.
We've never had a president before whose first job in government was president. This is not an entry-level position. This is president of the United States.
I understand what you're saying. I understand where you're going with this. Look at where this country is. People are occupying. And you know what our country is full of? Customers. Customers that are not satisfied, that are unhappy, that are not getting what they need. My husband's philosophy has always been the customer is always white.
Some have suggested that he doesn't know who the president of Uzbekistan is. He said that the Taliban was in Libya, that he may not know enough about world affairs to...
Maybe Herman screwed up a couple of times. Oh, Libya and the Taliban and Uzbekistan. Yeah, you know, maybe he made a couple of mistakes. He will surround himself, as he always has, with the smartest, brightest, most capable people. And some of those people, I just want to say right now, happen to be women.
Well, let's speaking of foreign affairs, do you mind if I bring up your marriage?
Mm-hmm. We have a terrific marriage. Terrific.
And he's a good husband.
The best. I could not ask for a better husband.
Are you aware of these women who are now coming forward?
Oh, am I aware? Have I heard? Molly Matlin's herd. They see a powerful man who's very wealthy and very smart. They see a ticket, a meal ticket, no pun intended, but it is a meal ticket.
And he's a kind man.
He would call, he would say, listen, Sylvia, this young woman, she's new in the restaurant business, she needs advice, I have to run to this dinner. I said, fine, you know, whatever you need to do, did you take your Prevacid? You know, he has a terrible stomach, terrible, but terrible.
Now, you've heard of Gloria Allred, right?
Gloria Allred. Gloria Allred. I'm sorry, no.
Now, a new woman. Have you heard of Ginger White?
Who?
Ginger White. She is an Atlanta businesswoman who came forward this week.
Ginger White. Ginger.
She says that she's had a 14-year affair with Herman Cain.
Ginger. Well...
Ginger White, she never worked in the Restaurant Association.
She's
from Georgia. She claims that Herman and she would rent a room at the St. Regis Hotel in Buckhead, Georgia, near your home. And they carried on a 14-year affair that was based solely on physical and emotional attachment, nothing to do with money, nothing to do with business. Have you seen this woman?
Well, give me the name. I have Herman's. He left his cell phone home again, as usual. He's so absent-minded. Give me that name again.
Ginger White.
Spell it.
W-H-I-T-E.
White. Yeah, that figures. Let me look here. Ginger White, 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 White. W-W-W-White. White. Did you say Ginger? Did you say Ginger White?
Ginger White.
You said Ginger White?
Yes.
Ginger White. Goddamn Ginger White! He is out at the goddamn St. Regis goddamn hotel while I'm sitting here howling for him to get his ass home! The son of a bitch! I am sick of this with his goddamn mustache and his stupid glasses. I can't do this anymore. I am done with this I have to hang up right now. I can't even. I'm so goddamn in front of a bitch with a fucking ass. Goddamn it.
Thank you, Sylvia Cain.
Oh, it's been such a pleasure. Thank you. Do you know when this will air?